Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the Ford 2.0 versus 2.3 EcoBoost. The Ford 2.0 EcoBoost is a 2-liter inline 4 engine initially introduced in 2010, and it had a major update in 2015, which is known as the twin scroll variant, as Ford had switched to a twin scroll turbocharger. The 2.0 EcoBoost offers anywhere from 203 up to 252 horsepower and 221 to 270 foot-pounds of torque. On the other hand, the 2.3 EcoBoost is a 2.3-liter inline 4 engine that was introduced in 2015. The 2.3 EcoBoost is ultimately a little bit of a newer engine and offers anywhere from 270 to 350 horsepower and 305 to 350 foot-pounds of torque. Outside of the small difference in displacement, both of these engines are actually very similar. They share the same base design, being a part of the Ford EcoBoost engine family. They are turbocharged, feature direct injection and double overhead cam. And a lot of the other design and aspects between the engines, like the aluminum block and cylinder head, are similar. So that clears up a lot of the basics and kind of background information with the 2.0 versus 2.3 EcoBoost engine. Let's go ahead and move on to one of the first major topics in this comparison, and that is reliability. Both of these engines tend to offer pretty good reliability overall. However, each engine does suffer from a couple issues that can be very severe and costly, and it's something that's really discussed frequently with these Ford EcoBoost inline 4 engines, and that is coolant intrusion, so coolant entering these cylinders. This does seem to be a lot more common on the smaller 2-liter engine than it does on the Ford 2.3 EcoBoost. So a little bit of a ding there for the 2.0 EcoBoost. This primarily affected 2015 to 2019 models. Ford did make some changes in 2020 to hopefully improve this for the long term and make this a non-issue moving forward. We have already heard of and seen a few cases of this happening on the 2020 plus engines. However, it does at least currently seem to be a lot less common than on that 2015 to 2019 model year range. Coolant intrusion can be a very serious problem on both of these engines. If coolant does enter these cylinders, even if it's caught in a relatively quick time frame, it can still cause some damage and long-term additional wear and tear and stress on the engine. If it's not caught quickly or the failure issue develops very quickly and very suddenly, it can lead to essentially complete engine failure. Outside of coolant intrusion, that was kind of the one major topic. One thing to mention briefly with the 2.3 EcoBoost is some of the early Focus RS models with the 2.3 EcoBoost experienced early head gasket failure. And so that is something to be aware of. However, that should mostly be a non-issue nowadays. Outside of that, both the 2.0 and 2.3 EcoBoost each have a couple other minor common problems here and there. For example, the 2.0 EcoBoost has some issues with cracks in the exhaust manifold. And with both of them being direct injected engines, over time, carbon buildup can be an issue on each engine. In summary, a Ford 2.0 versus 2.3 EcoBoost reliability. Generally, the 2.3 EcoBoost engine is going to be the more reliable one here. It has less of the coolant intrusion issues and generally just tends to have less common problems as compared to the 2-liter EcoBoost engine. We did film videos on both 2.0 and 2.3 EcoBoost common engine problems and reliability. So if you're looking to learn a little bit more about each of these engines, then check out those videos. But for now, we'll go ahead and leave it at that, with the main point being the 2.3 EcoBoost tends to be the slightly more reliable engine between the two. Moving on to performance, I touched on this a little bit in the beginning. Again, the 2.3 liter engine has those extra 0.3 liter of displacement and offers more power, torque, and performance from the factory. And that's going to hold true with aftermarket potential as well. If you're looking to pick up one of these engines to tune and modify them with bolt-ons or turbo upgrades, whatever the case. Now, one thing to keep in mind with both of these engines, this is especially true in the case of the 2.3 EcoBoost, is if you are looking to buy one of these engines and get into modifying it, it is important to be very cautious with your tuning and what mods you do, what kind of power and boost you're running, because both of these engines are already tuned fairly aggressively from the factory. When we look at the Ford Mustang Performance variant with the 330 horsepower output, and then the Focus Focus RS, which has a whopping 350 horsepower from the small 2.3 liter inline four. Those are already pretty impressive numbers for a small inline four engine like this. And when you start modifying them, even just a tune and basic bolt-ons can start pushing outside of the safe long-term reliability limits for the 2.3 EcoBoost. Ultimately, what it boils down to is the 2.3 EcoBoost did in some ways develop a nickname of the Eco Boom because it does tend to run into more internal problems when you do start pushing the engine outside of its limits, which again is very possible to do even just with a tune and simple bolt-on modifications. Ultimately, that wraps up most of our conversation on the Ford 2.0 versus 2.3 liter EcoBoost engines. In summary, what it really boils down to is these engines are very similar in their base design and structure. The 2.3 EcoBoost simply has the small displacement advantage coming in at 2.3 instead of 2.0 liters. And so as such, it is going to be the better performance engine both from the factory and in regards to aftermarket potential if you're looking to tune and modify one of these engines. And ultimately, the 2.3 EcoBoost also tends to be the slightly more reliable engine. Now, I know I talked about coolant intrusion and mentioned the 2.0 EcoBoost does have a couple extra common problems when compared to the larger 2.3 liter engine. That's not to say that either of these engines are problematic or disastrous engines by any means. Unfortunately, that coolant intrusion issue can be serious and costly, and so that does knock the reliability a little bit, especially in the case of that 2.0 EcoBoost, in which those problems tend to be more common on. And so a little bit of a downside to both of these engines, but outside of that, both the 2.0 and 2.3 EcoBoost tend to be reliable engines, and that's especially true if you keep up with proper maintenance, fix any issues if and when they do occur, and give your car and engine a little bit of extra TLC. And in that case, both of these engines can hold up well and be very reliable, great engines overall. So ultimately, I would choose the 2.3 EcoBoost engine personally, just because it does have a little more performance and is more reliable at the same time. But again, that's not meant to be a knock towards a 2.0 EcoBoost, and that can also be a great engine in certain applications. It really just boils down to what car and what engine you are looking for personally. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.